Singapore's The Straits Times has sounded the alarm of just how much debt Proton's main shareholder, Syed Mokhtar, has accumulated. 34 billion ringgit, almost as bad as 1MDB's 42 billion ringgit debt. The politically well-connected tycoon controls some of Malaysia's most diversified conglomerates, including MMC Corp, Malakoff, Sugar Business Tradewinds, Post Malaysia, and DRB Highcom, which owns Proton. An analyst was quoted as saying, Syed Mokhtar is known for injecting his private business into listed assets at the expense of minority shareholders. That's why his stocks don't have a strong following and trade at a discount. Fears are mounting that Syed Mokhtar's group could go under should the Malaysian economy slip into a major recession. According to The Daily, bankers and investors are worried about how the debts can potentially stress Malaysia's banking system. Top Glove has reported a 14% drop in third quarter net profit as the ringgit strengthens and raw material gets more expensive. Top Glove, which exports nearly 95% of its products, said net profit fell to 62.5 million ringgit. Revenue though was slightly higher at 672.3 million ringgit versus 661.2 million. The glove maker said while pricing adjustments were made, there's a time lag of 2 months before the cost increase reaches its customers. The company also suffered the impact of natural gas tariff hike. Margin for its nitrile glove segment was also eroded due to intense competition. It declared a dividend of 6 cents a share. Still, the company is upbeat on the industry's outlook, projecting a healthy 6-8% annual growth in demand for gloves. Now, as you already know, Sapura Resources is joining hands with KLCC Holdings to build Lot 91, a 52-storey tower at Jalan Kia Peng. Its MD, Shariman Shamsuddin, told us today the project will carry a GDV of 1.5 billion ringgit. He said the tower will be for rental purposes, so its cash flow and profits will be coming from that direction. Due for completion in the year 2020, the tower is about 1.2 million square feet and is attached to the convention centre. Sapura Resources got the shareholders' nod today to sell its education assets to Equinas, from which the proceeds will go towards this project. The company is disposing its stakes in Apit and Apit Lanka, as well as an Asia Pacific university for almost 247 million ringgit. The feasibility study for Penang Undersea Tunnel is still ongoing and expected to be done in 6 months' time. Yes, we did tell you yesterday that the firm in charge of the project, Consortium Zenith, had said that the study was put on hold. Well, it turns out that its chairman, Zarul Ahmad Zulkifli, had misspoken. Owning up to the mistake today, he said Zenith will continue with the study as it's only 17% to completion. Penang Chief Minister Lim Guan Eng too insisted the study was never halted. But the company still needs to get the DEIA approved. If that's rejected, the project will not go on and all costs will be borne by the contractor. He added that the construction for the tunnel might only start in 2022 and be completed by 2027. Was it purely a coincidence? A civil servant briefing by two federal agencies and 1MDB chief Arul Kanda in Sungai Besar found itself in the heat of the upcoming by-election. The forum, meant to serve as a talk on national issue, raised many eyebrows because of the timing and location. However, organizers said the forum was planned long ago as part of a nationwide road tour. An officer from the Implementation Coordination Unit of the PM's department said that this has been done all over Malaysia. Now that it's Selangor's turn, the focus area chosen is Sekinchang, so it has no relation to current politics at all. BN candidate for the by-election, Budiman Zodi, attended the forum. In contrast, DAP Assemblyman for Sekinchang, Ng Sui Lim, had no idea about the event.